I'm welcoming all for this today's program. Today, I'm focusing on AP style guidelines for figure constructions. Last week, we were discussing about the guidelines for creating effective tables. But today, I'm focusing on AP style guidelines for figure constructions. Particularly, when you're writing a research article for the dissertation or your thesis purpose, how we can create a figure in the AP format. That things I may focus in today. So hopefully you may be enjoy. See, normally when you look onto the figures, we have a lot of confusions. So what is big graph, what is big charts, what is big drawing, maps, photographs, lot of terminology we are using. But if you look on deeply, there is a difference among all. Just first I may focus on what is graph. Actually the graph, the term graph represent even the school days also, while discussing about graph, we are using x-axis, y-axis. Normally, for doing a graph or drawing a graph, we need a two-axis, x-axis, y-axis, for do a two-dimensional graph. If you want to do if you want to draw a three-dimensional, we need x-axis, y-axis, z-axis. But the main thing, if you want to draw a graph, we need a quantitative indices. This is very much needed. It means that your data is to be quantitative nature. It's to be quantitative nature and as well as the continuous nature. Sometimes it may be categorical also. But more or less, the data which is in the quantitative data, we can go for this kind of graphical representation of figures. Normally seen down, this is for the bar diagram I'm using. Here the example I'm using is a bar diagram. Normally, in the case of graph, we can go with bar graph or a line graph. So a lot of graphs we have, even the pie diagram, so pie graph, even some people are using a pie diagram. So there is a difference out there. But normally for drawing a graph, we need a two axis, x-axis and y-axis. Hopefully you understand the meaning of graph. But if you look onto the charts, what's the big chart? For looking onto the chart, it's to somewhat to be differ. What's the big chart in the sense, the chart consists of the non-quantitative information. For example, suppose I may focusing here, the non-quantity information. What is the non-quantity information represented in the sense? If your data is a quality nature, further you want to be show some kind of clarity input through the diagram representation, we can depend on the charts. The best example of the chart is nothing but the flow charts. We can use your flow chart for that. I'm going to be erase everything, then after that I move it. Yes. So I hope you understand the difference among the three. The two things, graph as well as the chart. For doing a chart, for drawing a chart, we need a non-quantity information, means the quality data. The best example of qualitative data representation of chart is nothing but see here, I added some kind of flow chart. So normally the flow diagram or flow charts, research designs or framework or structural equation modeling or confirmative factor analysis model or path analysis may come to the chart based representation of the data. Actually, if you look on deeply, particularly when you draw some kind of framework, or if you want to create a framework, we have to define some kind of flow charts. For representing your idea, for transacting your idea in a flow chart, we need to some kind of small shapes like a circle, triangle. So each shape having the unique meaning in the flow chart. That thing we have to be look on deeply. Otherwise, the flow chart's meanings to not be reach the people. So when you draw the charts, we have to look on to the symbols. See here, they're using a triangle, then rectangle. Then this also rectangle, then down there is a circle. This much of things they incorporated. The next figures representation I'm talking about drawing. So what's my drawing? Normally the drawing, we may draw in our hand only. It's like handwritten. It's like a freehanded diagram. You are using the term as a freehanded diagram. Normally, so for information, pictorically and can be used for illustrate. Normally it may be useful for drawing purpose. Suppose I may give this some kind of difference. I want focusing difference between the control group, experimental group with some kind of drawing representations. I can use this kind of drawing. See here, this is an experimental treatment, how the people are doing. like that they make some kind of unit diagram, and therefore it may come to the name of GROI. The next thing, maps. What is the map represent? Namely, the map is a display of the spatial information. Suppose when you look onto the India map, Pakistan map, or Afghanistan, we are usually termed as a map. The map means it's like a geographical census information. If you want to portray it, if you want to add it to a dissertation or research purpose, we can use the map as a figures. So I hope you understand the difference among the four things which I display in this week. One is called graph. For the graph, we need a quantity data. For drawing chart, we need a qualitative. Then for drawing it, we need, it's like a pictorial representation of our data, a pictorial representation of anything. Then map is like nothing but is spatial informations. So I hope you understand that the four important things. The three more important figures are plats, photographs, as well the multi-panel. See, in this graph, in this plat, I'm focusing on x-axis, y-axis. I hope these things, while you're discussing about the relationship, particularly for the correlation, we are using the term as a like scatter plot. So normally the plot diagram or plot graph, we may use it only for to understanding or to explore the relation between the two variables. Therefore, one kind of plot, one kind of figure is also it's called as a plot. The next thing is a photograph. Normally the photograph, we are using our mobile camera, some kind of digital camera we are using to capture the things. We can add these things for our dissertation purpose. Suppose you are doing experimental research, you are taking the class to the real classroom. That time you need to give some kind of originality. So some kind of document purpose, you may take some photos of your real classroom. That photographs you are adding to the dissertations. So that we may use the term as a photograph. It may be real pictures, we may use to some kind of digital camera or mobile camera. After taking, we can take a printout in a color, then we can keep it there. So normally where we can use this, and suppose you want to focus some kind of facial expression of someone's, we need to take a photo. That photo we have to add it. That is called as a photograph. Photograph represents the visual representation of information. The last figures I'm focusing on multi-panel. Multi-panel in the sense it's like a blending of two or three graph, charts, everything should be mingled with it's put together. It's called as a multi. The term itself, you can understand multi-panel. So multi means many. So if you're adding this kind of panel, see here, the first graph is like a histogram, the second like a line diagram or scatter, then third. So in the same figure, in the same page, so in the same image, it consists of the three panel, A panel, B panel, C panel. So like that, if you're combining lot of figures into a single graph, then we may use the term as a multi-panel figures. I hope you understand the difference of the difference among the each of the figures types. One is called graph, charts, drawing, maps, then plats, photographs, then multi-panel figures. Yes, the next thing, when you're drawing here or when you go for adding the figures, we need keep some kind of standard. What kind of standard while you are adding the graph or the figures into your dissertation? These are the standardness we have to be keeping. One is called simplicity. What is the simplicity? The simplicity in the sense we have to show our graph in a simple manner, not add lot of colors layer and add lot of data, then we can show to the people. It may confusing the while the people are watching the or seeing the graph. It should be very simple nature. The graph should be, the figure should be a very simple nature. Then the graph, it should be very clearly me focusing what they want to be, give that information to others. That clarityness is to be needed. Then each data of the graph or the figure should be continuous natures. It may be continuous nature. See, in this case, even they're using a multi-panel, the A diagram, B diagram, and C diagram somewhat to be linked with each other. So I'll see the case of the histogram, the first bar, second bar, third graph, the third bar, it will be continuous nature. So this kind of continuity is needed. And then finally, the last standardness of the good figures, information value. What is the information value? While you look onto the image itself, the particular figure itself, we may get a lot of input. So there is no need to be read the down things what they're writing. So the normally that what is the advantage of the graph? No, understanding the one paragraph or a 100 pages in a single diagram, it may give that much of input in a single diagram. So the all the 1000 page content or all the 100 page content, we can convert in single diagram, it's possible. But the single page diagram, it may give the informations of the 100 pages. That's why I'm always giving the assignment as a concept map. So this is that kind of information value you should be added while you're making a graph or a figures. Next thing, so when these are the principles we have to look on it while developing a or while construction a figures. We already discussed about the different types of figures. Just I may focusing on the principles while developing an figure. The first principles, a good figure augments rather than duplicate the text. For example, always we are giving the table representation, down the table explanation also there. So parallel we are adding the same table representation things as a graph. The problem with this, we don't use the figure as a supplement. So it's like a duplicate. So not as a duplicate, instead of it should be a supplement. So once you look onto the figure, that figure, it may be supplement of the previous text or the previous the table you added in the same page. So that kind of argument is needed rather than duplicate the text. Some people are they doing, they already writing the text to things in a word format, the same thing they convert as in graph. That thing is not needed. So the good figure represent, it's like a supplement of the instruction or a supplement of the content rather than the duplicate of the text. Convey only the essence and informations. Don't be put much information in a single graph. It may be distract the people. Omit visually distracting details. Some people, they're adding lot of colors layers, they're adding lot of numbers in a single graph. So don't be add that much of things. So it may be distracting the people. Then the graph or the figure should be very easy to read. Once they read, they may easy to understand. So it means that the line graph, labels and symbols, it should be used very clearly, as well as the proper acceptable terms we are using. Then the graph should be easy to understand, carefully planned and prepared. So we have to plan well as well as prepare well for constructing a figure. Then finally, consistent with and the same style as a similar figure in the same article. Suppose in the fourth chapter you have adding the five or six diagram or six figures, it should be uniformity based on the data types. You can change the types of the figure, but only the things you have to be look on to the consistent of your work. If you're adding the five or six diagrams or the figures, you should be consistent, the same type of a same style of the figure you have to be add while you making this one. So these are the principles. Then when you make it a graph or a figure, or that I already mentioned a lot of figures types are there, when you're making, you have to look on this much of things. So we have to check out, one is called images, whether the images are clearly it shows to the people. It means that even the layman also, after seeing the images, they may clearly capture the meaning. The next thing, lines. So when you're using the lines, it should be clearly visible, it should be smooth as well as sharp. For example, this is like a graph sheets. Suppose instead of this this kind of thin line, if I using a very thick line, so what it happened, the thick line, it may occupy the other centimeter also. Suppose I intend to go with this straight line, in the straight line in a very thin, but if I use as a thickness, what it happened, the thickness means, so I'm using this laser point, it's a very thick, the laser point thickness, it may goes above the line also, is out of the line also. Therefore that kind of boldness we want to use it while drawing. Therefore we are using this term sharp. So very sharp lines we have to use it. That's why we are always using a pencil, very sharp pencil to draw it. Then font. The font should be a simple to legible. It should be visible to all. So if you're adding, see here, they're adding this numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, that kind of labels they're using, but it will be very visible to all of us, that kind of things. The next thing, units. When you're making us a graph, we have to look on the units. It's nothing but legends. For example, the x-axis represent 1 centimeter equal to 10 units. For example, 1 cm equal 10 units. That kind of unit measurement we have to provide if we need it in the sensor. The next thing we have to focus in, we have to make it as a proper axis. We have to highlight what is x-axis here. There we put the y-axis, this is an x-axis. That kind of axis we have to clearly label. Then the element should be figure labeled. What is the elements? For example, this blue color represent male, that this maroon colors represent female. We have to highlight the elements properly. This kind of things we have to look while we're making a graph or a chart or a diagram. So I hope you understand what are the things we have to look on while you're developing a graph or a chart. The next thing, very important thing, the figure components. What's the figure components? The APA suggests that when you're developing or constructing any kind of diagrams, we need to follow, there's a five components approach. Five components, figure components, the same thing in the table also. So what are the table components we are using? There's a five component, one is called number, the second one is also title, in the case of table. But the third one, it's called heading. So the last class we are discussing heading. So this is we are using as here. The last one is always a note. The last one is always note. So in the previous, the same kind of five component approach, we are using the figure table also. The same thing, but somewhat different here. We are using different terms like number, title, image. So in the case of this one, in the case of table, we, here it's called as a heading. Here the main body, this is called body in the case of table, but here it's called legend. Then finally it's called note. So these are the five components we have to look on it while developing a graph or a figures. See here, what is a number? So the same thing in the table also, we are using a number like table one. Here we are using as a, instead of table as a name, we are using as a name as a figure one or figure two. Where the number should be available. So where we have to appear, the number should be above the figure. So just I'm going with this image, then you can understand. See, the first component is figure, that number. So where the number is available, see here, the number, it will be the left, it should be the left alignment. It should be the left alignment, but in the bold. So this thing's very important. This is a graph that in the above the graph or in the above the figure, only the figure number is there. It may be a bold, and they are using the number as an alphanumeric. They are not using as a, they are not start from the zero. They are using as a number one as a alphanumeric, not in a Roman letters and all. This is the first component. What is the second component? It's a title. See the same thing in the table also. There we are using as a italic letter. Italic letter. So the same kind of italic letters are here. See here. This is the first component. This is second component. I hope you are getting into. You can understand the component. Just I'm using the pen. The first component, this is the first component. That is called figure number. Then second component, this one. The second component, this is a figure title. So the first component, I'm writing this one. This is the first component. The figure title is second component. The third component is the image. The entire image. See here. The entire image is a third component. This is the third component of the figure. But in the case of the case of the table, it's called heading. But here we are using the third component, say image. See, in this case, in the image consists of axis. First is the axis. So that's why they're using graph, chart, drawing, map, plot, anything it may be as an image. But the things you have to look on it. So while you making a say chart, for this is for the graph, I'm telling. When you're drawing a graph, we need an axis. This is a y-axis. This is a y-axis. This is an x-axis. Then they are adding the label. This is called labels. So in the down x-axis, they're giving the label. The label of x-axis, the same way, the label of y-axis, they added like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. They're adding. So this is a labels. The next thing, after adding the label, this kind of title is needed. This is for the y-axis title. Work attitude, this is an x-axis title of the day. So this everything's may come under the image. So this is called as the third component of the figure. And this also the data point, even the data point we are using, this data point. So this entire data point, the entire data point also, the diagram representation of the graph. Okay, so from the graphic representation we can understand the dataness. So this thing is called as a image. The fourth component is called legend. What is the legend in the sense? So the legend is focusing, see here, this is a legend. So the legend, we may add it inside or down. Actually, we may use inside the diagram or inside the graph. Even we can add this in down, or we can add in the left side also. What is the legend in the sense? Actually, in the diagram, they are using some kind of small symbol. So that symbolness, we have to give the clarity. Like, so whenever you're using unit, we are writing, when you're drawing a graph in the by handed, no, we are writing the side as here, some kind of unit measurement, like 1 centimeter equal 10 units, 2 centimeter equal to 20 units, that kind of things we are writing. Parallelly, we are writing the color mark. Suppose we are using some kind of colorness for male, female, we have to tell the red color for the male, the yellow color for female. That kind of legends we have to give. This is called legend, the fourth component. I hope you understand the fourth component. This is the fourth component, legends and key. The fifth components of the graph or the figure, this is the fifth components. So like a note, the same kind of note is available. We may use it in this in the table also, according to the AP, the figure notes. It may be down, it is the down of the figure only. So I hope you understand the five component approach of the figure. Once again, I may highlight the five component approaches. The one is called number. It may be the above the figure left alignment. The font is to be bold. Then if you look onto the title, second component, one double space below the figure number. What is the one double space? See here, the figure heading and title, there is a spaces in between. Just I'm clearing this one. See here, there is a spaces in between here. This spaces is one double spaces. Then that is called title. Then the italic title. Then the next is called image. The image consists of chart, graph, photograph, anything. But it like the it's, from this only we can understand the entire illustrations and the data things and all. See, this is the entire thing is called chart. So the images. This part is called, the third part is called images. The next, what is the fourth component? So the fourth component is talking about the legend. What is the legend? The legend, it may locate on the side. So where the graph having these spaces, here the graph having the spaces, the diagram, that's what they are adding here. Otherwise, we can add this legend in down or the right side also. So that kind of even the top also, as we like, wherever the gap is there, we can add it. But don't put it in the above the line. So it may be disturb the lines. So we have to add where it's suitable. If it have empty space, we have to add this kind of legends. The legends is talking about the symbols, which are the symbols you are using the third component. This is the third component. The third component, if you are using any kind of symbols or any kind of important things, for that if you want to describe the things, for describing the third component things, we can use the legends. Even we can give some kind of colorness, or if you are using some kind of pattern difference between the two graphs, we have to explain this one. The last component is called a note. Normally the note are the same kind of figure, the table also, there is a three kinds of notes, like general, specific, probability. General means if you want to highlight some kind of abbreviation, you can say general notes. If you want to look onto a specific thing, suppose you are asking, you want to give some explanation about a single line or single x-axis, you can go with a specific note. Suppose if you're talking about the probability value, like the p-value, you can go with the probability types. It may be appear in the below the figure. Example, definition of abbreviation, corporate attribution. I'm giving some other examples. I hope you now understand how it will be looking on. Just I'm going to this one, after that I may emphasize that some kind of examples to you. Figures, numbers. So these are the things we have to look on it. While you look on the first component, the numbers, it should be Arabic numbers. Example, figure, there is a space 1, figure 2 and figure 3. So we can use only the alphanumeric. I hope you understand the numeric types. We are using Roman letters normally, but in this case we can use the alphanumeric. You know these things also. We are adopting is here India Arabic numerals. What is India Arabic numerals in the Indian sense? We are using the numbers 0 to 10. That the expansion only is 11, 12 and all. So we are using a Indo-Arabic numerals. Why is called Indo-Arabic numeral in the sense? Indians contributing, they found zero as a number. They are contributing the zero as a number to the entire world. Therefore, they are using the terms of Indo-Arabic numerals. The other letters like 1 to 9 numbers, they found the Arabic peoples. Therefore, we are using the Indo-Arabic numbers. But in the case of the APA, we can use the only the Arabic numerals because our graph or a diagram, we start with the number from 1 and it's not from the 0. Then assign numbers in all the figures in the order. First, suppose in the chapter, you have the 5 graph or 5 diagram. The first diagram, you can give the number 1. The second diagram, you can give the number 2. The same order you have to give. Don't be shuffle the order of the diagrams with the numbers. Then font should be bold. It may be appear the flesh left. Then it appendix figures that appear in the appendix follow in different numbers. Same. Suppose you are adding this graph or the diagram in the appendix part, we can go with the different numbers. Just I'm going to be emphasize in the Word document how we can add the numbers. See here, I'm opening one documents, one Word file here. There I may focusing how we can use it. So this is a Word document. So I'm giving some kind of example. Figure 1. See here, the figure 1, I'm making everything is a single color for understanding purpose. I'm making a black font. The figure 1, it is a bold. It is bold. I'm using alphanumeric. I hope you understand. This is one is called the first component. We have to go with figure 1. Figure is a name and the number 1. Suppose if you go with the second one, what I'm doing here, see here, figure 2, figure 3. This kind of orderness is needed. This kind of orderness is needed. Yes, and boldness, it should be left alignment. And from this one, we have to go with the control 2. There is a 2 spaces needed. The title as well, the number, this is the second one, is called title. The title should be below the 2 line spaces, 1 double spaces. Therefore, I'm giving the 1 double spaces. It will be control 2, this things he knows. Control 2 is a short form of the 2 spaces. Otherwise, we go with here, there is an option called paragraph. In the paragraph, you can give the double spaces. So this one, you have to keep it while making the number as well as the title. So I hope you understand the first component. The second component, I'm going with this. The second component that also I'm focusing, one is called figure title. The figure title, every figure is a brief, but clear and explanatory title. Don't give you say 2 lines or 3 lines a graph title. It's not fair. It should be a brief, but it should be clear and explanatory title. The content, the basic content of the figure should be easily informed from the title itself. The font, the italic, appear below the figure number, double space, this is important, double space, and figure number as a title. So these things you have to look on it. See here, the appear below the figure number and double spaces. Avoid overlay. Suppose if you're adding 2 or 3 things, it may be overlaying. That kind of things you have to be avoid. That kind of things you have to avoid. These things we have to look on it while you are making a figure title. Just I'm going to emphasize the use of Word document. See here, in this case, this is a title, number, graph number, this is a title. This is a title, italic. Do you know the short form of the italic? We have to type control I is a short form. Otherwise, how we can be changes a italic in the sense? Select it here. Once you select here, there is an option italic. So if you click I, automatically the italic font may change. Now the title should be very brief. See here, the diagram or flow chart of the 2 extended designs. So I'm going with the flow chart. From this, we can easily understand this diagram or this flow chart is talking about the 2 extended designs. So we can easily understand this one. The same thing, the flow chart of the result design, then flow chart of the variable of the study. So I'm adding only the flow charts. From the title should be very brief. Don't type the 2 lines. For example, just I'm going with 2 or 3 lines, just for the example I'm taking. So don't go with this much of big one. So the people are adding this much of big things. I'm just to copy and paste it, the same thing. But if you go with it, this kind of very broad or very big title, it's not fair. It's always the topic should be very brief. The title should be very brief, but it may convey the entire information about the chart to the audience or the readers. Yes, the second components, I hope you understand. The third components I may focus on now. What is the third components? Figure images. This is the main component. When you look on the figure images, these are the things we have to look on it, on the size, proportion, spelling, the numbers within the figure, shadings, colors, panels. So these are the important things we have to look on it while you're making your figures. See one by one, we will see one by one. When you look on to the figures, size and proportion of elements, each element in your figure must be large enough to sharp enough to be legible. So I already mentioned that the x-axis, y-axis, when you draw, it will be very sharp in nature. Don't make it a very thick line. Instead of you go with a thin line, that's good. And always you see that sans serif font. We already discussed while you're talking about the paginations. So we always use sans serif font. It's nothing but the Arial, Calibri, this kind of fonts we have to use while you're labeling the numbers in the x-axis, y-axis. The font size should be no smaller than 8 or more than 14. So we have to look on it. While you draw a graph, the font size of the number, the labeling of 1, 2, 3 of x-axis, parallel the labels of the y-axis should be not smaller than 8, more than 14 points of the sans serif fonts. Then as a general guidelines, cross symbol should be about the size of the lowercase. This also we have to look on it. We have to use the lowercase on it. In the case of spelling, sometimes if you want to use the number is a very broad term. If you want to use a short form, you can use the short form, but universally accept the short form only. Same case, the percentage, if you want to type the percentage is very big. Instead of that, you can use the term as a percentage as a symbol. This kind of thing is acceptable. The spelling, capitalization, numbers, it will be very, you have to look on very properly. Even if you are using statistics, Greek letters or unit measurement, we have to use it here, acceptable format only, acceptable format. The next thing, shading. Suppose that you are focusing some kind of graph like, I'm telling the graph like a bar diagram or a pie diagram. Sometimes you may focus on each bar is a different color or different shading. It's permissible, but don't use much shading. It may be distract the people. So it will be limit the number of different shading always. And different shading are used to distinguish bar segments of your graph is good, but don't make it much colorful. It may distract the people. If more than two shadings are needed, if you need it, you can use some kind of patterns. Patterns, instead of adding a graph color, we can use some kind of pattern like a cross line or some kind of dots. We can use as a patterns. That kind of shading we can use it. Otherwise, you can use a color, but it's good for the color only for the dissertation, not for the article where you're submitting to the some kind of journals. Because some journals is a black and white journal only. Most of journals, they won't accept the color based graph and all. So while you're sending the article to the publications or journal, you have to better to be avoided. Otherwise, you can look on to the which format they're asking. That format you can share to them. For the dissertation, it's not a worry. You can use it any color. The panel, I already mentioned that there's a multi-panel. The same graph having the two or three, and the same figure having two or three panel of diagrams like a line diagram, then scatter diagram. If you want to blend it, you can use the panel. So normally the top panel, left panel, the middle panel, this kind of thing is there. But we have to focus in the panel number. If you are using the first diagram as a line graph, you can use the panel E. The second one, you can panel B. Like that, we can use the different panel numbers while making. So I hope you understand the third components. The fourth component is called legends. If you are using some kind of symbols in the third components of the images, we have to describe that one, or we have to give some kind of explanation about the symbol in the legend part. Normally the legend is explaining any symbols or line styles which are using the image portions. The legend is the integral part of the figure. We have to add the image itself. Only the figures that have the symbols, line styles, shadings, needs, definition should include legends. This we already discussed. When possible, place the legends within the below the image instead of a side of avoid having the empty spaces around the legends. It's better we can use the empty spaces, place legends within, otherwise below. So they're suggesting like this. And don't need to be add the right side or left side. Better to add in below, otherwise inside the images they tell. The fourth component, the last component, figure notes. These things I'm focusing after I'm doing some demonstration directly. The figure notes, while you look on the figure notes, I already mentioned the figure notes is the last component of your figure. The same thing the note is available in the table also, like the table notes are written down. It's the fifth components of the figure as of the table. Normally, it's like an explanation. Suppose if you are using any kind of abbreviation, that abbreviation you want to give the explanation as a text, we can use as a figure notes, that part. And normally, generally specific and probably there's a three types of notes are available. I can specify the three types of notes. See here, the general notes, suppose in this day, I hope you are seeing here they are using some kind of copyright informations. Because the reason they are using the general notes. Normally, the general notes is maybe of the first paragraph, the first paragraph after the diagram. This is a part of the general note. It may down the images, but it's the first paragraph. But the specific note, if you want to add, it's the second paragraph after this general notes. If you want to see here, this diagram is talking about the path analysis. There is a separate headings. I want to highlight these headings things. I want to highlight these headings things as a some kind of text explorations or explanations. I can use a specific. I can use a specific paragraph. It may be down the general note only. Suppose I want to use the probability note. Like if you want to emphasize some kind of p value, see in this diagram some kind of p values are there, some kind of scores are there. If you want to highlight whether it's significant or not significant, we can use this kind of probability based note. So always the note should be down of the graph only. These are the five components we have to look on it while making. These are some of the sample figures. Before going to the sample figures, just I may highlight in the Word file how we can create a diagram. So this is only flow chart. Just I'm going to highlight how we can create a graph with the use of Word documents. Just I'm going with the figure 4. So figure 4, what font we have to use it? So here we can use the bold. So I'm using a bold. Is it a left alignment? I'm using bold. It's a left alignment. I'm keeping. Then in down, I want to add the histogram representation of something I want to add. Just I'm going with the histogram. Otherwise, like a pie diagram or bar diagram. It's a bar chart. I'm going with a bar chart. So I'm going with a bar chart or bar graph. Okay. You can use a bar chart. Normally, we are using the terms a bar chart or bar graph we are using. Otherwise, bar diagram. So I'm using a bar diagram. Which one you want, you can use it. So I'm going to use a bar graph. It's a bar graph representation of gender. Representation of gender. This is title. But the title should not be near, I already mentioned, it should not be near bold. It should be italic near San Francisco. So italic, I'm going to italic. So the first title number as well as this differences, that line spaces, two spaces. How we can give the two spaces? Go with the paragraph, then go with the double spaces. So you can give like this. So now the two spaces happen. But this two spaces is very big because some kind of spaces happen. Just I'm giving the paragraph. I'm removing this as a zero. Only I fix a double here. So then click OK. Now the double space may come. After this, we can add the graph now. I'm going to add the one bar diagram. How we can add the bar diagram? For this, we can go with the insert options. In the insert, we are getting the chart options. Just I'm doing the demonstration how we can do your chart with this. So if you go with the chart, we may get the plenty of chart types. Plenty of chart types. So we have to select which chart we need. Which charts we need, that we have to select it. So here default is coming. If you keep it, the cursor is automatically coming. So here that figure APA demo, already the APA format also is coming. Just I'm keeping, so it's default one graph is coming. I like to delete this one, but yeah. So I'm going to delete this one. 1 minute, it becomes a very big font. Yeah, so I deleted. Just I'm going to once again, where we can go with insert. If you go with insert, you may get the chart. In the chart, if you want to get more, functionally currently limited, actually it's make currently limited this one only. It's better I may create a because I'm using the other one, no? Already some kind of graph is there. I'm opening as a new one, new blank documents. There I'm making as a some, because I'm typing as heading, that's why that kind of limitation may comes. Without making a title, just I'm going to insert. There I'm clicking the charts. Once I click the charts, I may get the plenty of chart types. See here. This much of plots are available. There, if you want a line chart, pie chart, bar chart, area, then scattered plot, then stock, surface, radar, tree map, lot of graph is there. Even if you go with the histogram, box, Whistler, box plot graph, which one you want, you can go with this. Just I am going with the bar diagram or column diagram. Just I am going with the color diagram. I'm selecting this one and click OK. Once I click OK, one diagram may comes. Apparently there is a chart date. So suppose I like to go with male and female of the male and female. I'm giving the male and female. So only the two group is needed. That's why I'm skipping this one. They're giving some kind of templates. From the templates we can easily modify. Just I'm going with some kind of mark, average mark of the different subject like mathematics, math, max, science, social science, and I'm going to last as a language. So I'm giving the I'm going to change the scores here. So there is a max mark, science mark, social science, and language. So I'm changing the mark here. Here the only the point is that I'm going to make as a point like a 66% mathematics. Then girls are 73% in the mathematics. The science, the boys are 78, girls only 73. Then social science, boys is 79, social science, girls is 75. Language, the boys is only 67, girls is 79. So like that, I'm giving the chart. See here, what it happened? Once I give this pose, automatically this my chart is changing here. So now I've given the chart. So now the chart is available. Sorry, what I did in the sense, without saving, like click this one. That's why it happened. That's why it's happened. Just I'm skipping this. Oh, this and another. This. Just saying, yeah. So now the score is coming. Sorry, the score which I allotted previously comes here. Suppose if we want to alter the mark. So here the problem. So I'm here the problem, no? So the problem with this, the language instead of 6, it comes in different. Suppose if I want to be added, I can go with the data sheets. I can change this one. This is the max style. So we can go with which mode we want to be do the alteration. You can do it. So like that, we can do the customization here. That kind of customizations. Here, if you want to add the elements of the charts, if you want access title, chart title, chart data labels, everything it will be available here. So we can go with, if you want to change the legends, if you want to change like this, if you want to change this mode or this mode, which mode you want the legends for, the layout they're given, this much of layouts they're providing. Suppose if you want to edit data, I'm going to edit data. So in the edit data, I may change the data. Yeah. So previously, yeah, this comes like this. Better, I'm select this graph and yeah, now it automatically changes. Just I'm doing once again the same process. I'm going to edit data. I'm doing the edit data for demo purpose once I'm doing. So I'm going with male and female. This is male. This is a female. I'm doing male and female. I don't like to go with the code components. I'm deleting this one. I'm going with this category. I'm going with mathematics, max, science, social science, language. And language. So I'm giving the 3-4 subjects based on mark I'm giving as only as here. Yeah. So male, I'm giving us here this like a percentage. I'm giving the boys is 66%, girls is 76. Then the science aspect, the boys is good. That's why I'm giving some kind of scores. Now the social science of the boys may be good. That's why I'm giving the 70, the girls is 65. Then language, normally the girls should be good. That's why I'm giving boys is only 70, girls is 83 or 82. Okay, like that I'm giving the scores. So after giving the score, the chart is ready. So I'm closing this one. Once I close this one, so the scores all it comes like this. Now I'm going to do the alterations in this graph. So according to the API, we can give the separate chart title. Therefore, I want to delete this chart title. How we can delete the chart title? So if you keep the cursor in the above the chart, you may get this plus symbol. The plus symbol is asking that axis. What is the axis? This x-axis, y-axis is already there. Suppose you want to add the axis title. According to the AP, we need the title. Nothing but the title, what is the x-axis represent, what is y-axis represent. That's why once I click the axis title, you are getting the axis title as heading. I'm giving the access title. So I'm giving this access title. So now the access title is coming. In the access title also, above the chart or center, it's better go with the center only. So it go with the center or above the chart, as you like, you can go with this. This is for the chart title. I don't like to chart title, therefore I'm removing the chart title. I'm talking the axis title, whether it want a primary horizontal, primary vertical, this asking. If you need a more option, you can go with this. The next thing, data labels. Data labels, see here, here we are not getting the scores or max of the male and female. So if you want to keep it the data labels, it's asking the data labels. Automatically from the data, from the graph itself, we can understand, oh, this is male 66, female 76. That scores is visible, that is called data labels. Even if you want to focus the data labels inside, it's called center, inside end, inside base, outside end. So which one you want, you can go with this. So I like to go with inside itself. So I'm going with inside. And if you want to change the data table, so like this table or center, normally it comes like this only. So this is a data table. So if you keep the data table, this is a data table, somewhat the data table may change. I don't like to go with the data table, that's why I'm avoiding. Then the grid line is important. Suppose I like to go with the grid line. Instead of a color, I can go with the line based, you can go with this line. These things, that's the fourth component, is called legends. Actually, the legends is to be the side. Better I can go with the legend, it's to be the down, bottom. So now the bottom is come. So if you go with the left, you can go with the left. If you want to keep us on top, you can keep it top. Better it will go with the bottom or inside the graph. So therefore I'm keeping it as a bottom. Then if you need a trend lines, it's not needed. That is called trends. The same diagram, if you add the other trends like a line diagram, you can go with the trends diagram. So if you need it, you can go with this. Then after making this, just I like to avoid this line. Just I'm selecting this line, I'm deleting. So once you select this line, if you're deleting, this line may goes. That's like the back trend lines. Now the x-axis, y-axis is there. If you want to give the title, you can give the title. This was subjects. So we have to give the title. Subjects as a bold. I'm giving it as a bold. Bold. Then this is a percentage. Percentage. Or as a mean score. I input as a mean score. Mean score. This is a mean scores of these subjects. Now from this diagram, we can easily understand the subject max, the blue color represent male, this is called legend. Blue color represent male, orange color represent female. From this they can easily understand from the mathematics, boys are 66, females are 76, therefore females are better than boys. In the case of science, boys are 78, females 75, they may easily understand. So this kind of legends is needed. This is called images. Now I am adding the title also. I am adding the title, figure 1. Then that this is called bar chart. Bar chart. Bar chart of gender. So yeah. Bar chart representation of gender with respect to the marks. Marks average. Okay, just I'm giving us a heading. Bar chart representation of the gender with respect to the marks. Just I'm going with the control I. It's not a bold, so just I'm removing the bold. So I'm removing the bold. Only the italic is needed. Only the italic. But this is a bold. I'm giving us a bold. The next thing, we have to keep the two spaces in between. I'm flipping. I'm going with the space paragraph. I'm giving the two spaces. I'm giving the two spaces, double spaces. I'm removing this spaces here. Then, okay. So this kind of structure thing we can do it. There's a first component, number. The second component, title. The third component is also available. What is the third component represent? There's a graph, like images. The fourth component is this kind of legends. The fifth component is note, where we have to add the note. So we have to write the note in down if we need it. It's not compulsory, we can add the note. Just I'm going with the control B note. There we can type that note, important things, if you need it. So the above diagram is talking about the above diagram. The above charts describe the main scores, describe the differences. Differences of the differences, differences between male and female, with respect to the means, with respect to the means course of different subjects. So if you need, you can give this. This should be not in bold, and remind this bold of this one. Yes, so this is called note. This is called general note. This is where we have to design the chart. Actually, this kind of outer layer is not needed. So if we click here, we can get it into, we can remove this kind of layer. If you go with chart area, the outline is asking. The outline, if you want to remove the outlines, so no outline. So that outline won't be there. So we don't add that kind of square image. Just that kind of outline is not needed according to the API. Only the thing, you have to add this heading. So the heading should be a bold. This title, the title of the chart. Then this one is needed. There's a number, y-axis number, then x-axis numbers, everything. X-axis description legends are there. So I hope you understand how we can make it this kind of diagram. Fairly, I may be focusing on another example to create a scatter diagram. Just I'm going with insert. I'm going with chart. In the chart, I'm going with the scatter diagram. Scatter represent the relationship based. If you want to do any graph, you can go with this. I click OK. So once I click OK, the scatter diagrams may comes here. We can give the title. For example, I'm going to write here. Compare the relation to intelligent achievement. I'm giving this some kind of random scores of each individual, like 56, 53, 34, 23, 45. I'm giving some kind of random score, 56, 65, 54. I'm giving the 5 scores. Parallel, I'm giving their achievements mark also. Just I'm giving the 54, 52, then 32, 34, then just giving some kind of randomizations based on the row score, 46, 43, 55, then last one, 66, and give the 62. Okay, so one more score is missing, 43. Yes, I'm giving these scores like this. So now the scatter diagram is coming. Just I'm close this one. Yeah, once I close it, the diagram is ready. Now this is scatter diagram. This is a scatter diagram of x-axis, y-axis is there. Suppose I want to add the legends, these things, you know, so x-axis, y-axis already there. If I want to add the title, I can go with the title. Then this is a chart title. I don't like to go with the chart title, that's why I'm removing. If you need the data libraries, you can give the data libraries, I will skip it. Then this is called data error is not needed. Then legends is needed. So legend is needed. The blue color represent achievement. Then because we are using only one legend, therefore no need. If you're going with the X and Y, only the legends needed. I'm bringing the legends. It's not needed for the legends because I'm not using any kind of extra symbols here. Suppose I am using two lines. So suppose I'm going with the trend lines, trend line of male and female. So I'm going with the linear. There's a linear lines coming. There, if I use a special character, we may use some kind of legends is needed. Here, legend is not needed. Yes, I'm skipping keys. If you want to give the title, you can give the title here. Then the next thing, we can give the title, figure number. I'm giving the figure 2, then title. For example, scatter plot. Scatter plot. I'm giving the control 2, the space. Over here, I'm going with paragraph. Then double space. Okay. Then click OK. This is bold, this is italic. Then I don't go with this kind of line is there, no? We have to avoid that line also. Therefore, I'm going to right click. If you go with outline, you may get the no outline. So now this is a graph. Suppose you don't like this inside the line also, just to select and delete it. So inside the line also, you may go in, then delete. So inside also, there is no line. So this is the way we have to add a graph. So we have to give the x-axis, this x-axis achievement. Then y-axis is here. I think the x-axis is intelligence. Yes, x-axis is intelligence. The y-axis is achievements. Based on the x-axis score, the y-axis may lies here. Now x-axis here, achievement. So I have to go with bold to understand these things to others also. Just I'm going to bold, this also bold. Just I'm going to tell some kind of sample figures also. So this PPT also I'm sharing you. These things we already discussed. So see here, this for the bold graph, the title. This for the number, title, this a graph. But this graph having the two parts, low risk and high risk. That's why they're giving some kind of heading. This is called legends. I hope this is called legends. You are getting the, just I'm going with that. I'm marking the laser point. This is a legends. This is a note. This is note. Then this is a the title. The title of the x-axis. This is a axis title. Y-axis title. The same thing. The sample line graph. This for legend. This for the note. This is a title. This for the number. This for the title. So every graph are figures having the five components. This for the flow charts. Therefore, number, flow chart, title, then. Flowchart, for the flowchart and all, the fourth component is not needed. That's called legend is not needed. Only the note is needed. The note. So, but the note is italic. Kind of see the note they made it italic. This is also another flowchart. And this is like a diagram. This is like diagram. The same component of approach are there. So this is a diagram they're using. Like a chart also. So sorry, this is a diagram. The previous one is a chart. This is a diagram like experimental and experimental things they are explaining, how they're doing the experimentations. They're using a type number, then the design as a italic, as a title, then this is a diagram they're given. If you need the headings, you can give the headings, then down is a note. This is for the map. If you're adding some kind of map in your dissertation, you can keep this kind of format for adding the map. This is for the scattered plot. I'm already mentioned the scattered plot. So the two lines are there, that's why they're using the legends. If you're going to only one line, only for legends. Then this is for the other dimensional image. This is for the photograph. The photograph also, the title, number title is needed. In down, you have to add the three panels diagrams. The top panel, you have to give some kind of descriptions as a note. And the next 2 months, sample complex, multi-panel. See here, this is multi-panel. The same graph, the panel A, panel B, panel C, panel D, panel E. If you're adding 4 or 5 graph in the same diagrams, we can use this kind of panel approaches. These are panel approaches I'm showing here. Here we can emphasize that each panel is a different number, A, B, C, D. Then down we can go with the note. Other first 2 parts is same only. So the similarly, this is called MRI. So if you are using MRI figure, if you are using some kind of dissertation work, we may add this kind of MRI scan also. That time you can use this kind of image representation of data. This is for the sample display genetic material. If you have science background, if you want to do some kind of science research, we have to show like this. So this is the way we have to add the diagram representations or the figure representations while you're making say API format. I hope you understand the entire guidelines, and I already did the demonstration also. Hopefully it may be useful for you. Thank you. Jai Bharat.